Sometime ago, it's
hi guys, and welcome to today's Christmas video. We're going to be making mince pies. Here are the ingredients: 340 grams of flour, 1 tablespoon of caster sugar, 2 tablespoons of icing sugar for sifting or dusting at the end. You will need 200 grams of diced butter, 300 grams of minced meat. You can find minced meat in like Tesco's or Waitrose. We got ours in Waitrose. You'll also need 3 egg yolks, or if you're using large eggs, you will need 2, and your whites of your egg for the end for brushing your mince pies before they go to the oven.
Now you have to go and live with one who's been naughty. But I may keep poor Joe crying in electricity. You pollute the air.
So now we've turned our oven to 180 degrees Celsius. And we're going to start sifting our flour into a bowl. Is all mixed in with the butter. It resembles like breadcrumbs, big breadcrumbs of flour and butter. Next, we very quickly add in our egg yolks, and then you stir it, but you have to do this really quickly, otherwise it turns, you get clumps of egg yolk, and it's really not very good. So you quickly stir it. We do this so the because having butter and flour alone, it doesn't. You need something to combine it. So by doing this, it gives a good thing to combine it. Okay.
Some time ago at Santa's place, up in the old North Pole, there lived a lump of apple.
Now you bunch it all together to form a dough. Joe, Joe, the lump
of coal, happy as a lump can be. He just wants to keep Santa warm and make the elves cozy. But Santa Claus.
Okay, so now our flour, butter, and eggs have resembled a dough. We put it in our bowl and put it in the fridge for 10 minutes to chill. Whilst that's in the fridge, we can get our tins. I'm using small ones. I'm using small ones because my family really like small bite-sized mince pies. So we need to butter them. and then they'll be ready to, so then the dough will be ready to roll and the tins will be ready to put the dough in. Okay, so now we've buttered our trays and waited a bit, our dough should be ready. Oh, and if any of you guys are wondering where my sister is, she is in the lounge in Cartwheels. So we're gonna go get our dough. Okay, so we've got our dough. There shouldn't be much difference in it apart from coldness. And we've used these cookie cutters. So we've got a round one. In a set, I think it would be the third smallest, well, the third biggest one. But that's if you're using small tins. We've got a star to go on top and a snowflake print to go on top of the star. We've got our rolling pin and we need some flour. So we need a bit of flour. So you need to roll your dough out to about 5 millimeters. No, yeah, half a centimeter deep. To a precious jewel. So take me in your hand, young man, and squeeze with and all your might. Then you can let's turn your pain and anger into something out. That shines bright. The way I do this is carefully lift up my dough and I get a tray. For me, when I first tried this, they kept breaking in the middle, so I've had to push them down very gently so they don't break. Here, so they will look something like this when you first put them in. And then if you get a butter knife, any knife, but for me, butter knife is the best, you can scrape that side there, and then you can push it down a bit more and scrape it and then carry on. But Santa Claus had other plans, but Joe won't bake for day. Joe, you're just the lump I need, come join me on my sleigh. Okay guys, so now we have done our mince pies, we need to fill them. So if I move the dough to one side and get our 300 grams of mince mix. We use vegetarian ones, but I think you can get meat ones still. We get 2 teaspoons for the little ones, and we only use half because then we scrape it off like that, and you fill it all the way to the brim, like that. You pollute the air with CO2, mercury. Joe, Joe, the lump of coal fell down upon his knees. I don't want to live with the naughty kid. Don't make me Santa, please. So this is what Santa should be like. Oh, you stupid lump. You're just the thing to teach this brat that Santa ain't. Okay, so now our mince pies are full, so I've done two. We are going to start cutting out the little shapes to go on top. I've got a star here and a snowflake. I've also done big ones here, two big ones, and I was just doing some nice little decorations there, just out of shortcrust pastry. So for the big ones, I've got a bigger star to go on top, and for the little ones, a little star. So if we get our excess pastry and we roll it out, I can cut out some stars. So that's four stars cut out. It turns him hard and cruel. But I know how. But the problem is they stick. So you're gonna have to get a flat knife just to scrape them up. Squeeze with all your might. Let's turn your pain into something that shines bright. So these little stars are good. And now I press the snowflake print. So I'll put them up and they end up looking like that. Then you get a mince pie tray, place it on top and push the sides down like that. And then you carry on with all of your other little mince pies. Just wants to keep Santa warm. Okay, so now we can put our, now our mince pies are ready. We have, I've just dusted them with a bit of icing, no, not icing sugar, caster sugar, and brushed a bit of egg yolk on top. Well, not egg yolk, the spare, the egg white, so the spare bits from your egg yolk. And now we're gonna put them in our preheated oven at 180 degrees Celsius for about 15-20 minutes until they're golden brown. Well, not really 20 minutes, about 10-15 minutes. Yeah, until they're golden brown. All after Joe, you're in for a surprise. You're not a special Christmas gift, you're just a booby prize.